this episode, you can see me trying to drive the car without fuel. Show you how my layout for the monster truck engine is planned right now. I showed you this engine before. It's 390cc stockwise. Later it's going to be a stroker, so it's going to have 430cc in the end. And in the wheelies, the supercharger sits in the front of the engine. Get to this way. Yeah. So in the wheelies, there's a huge aluminium plate mounted to this case, and the supercharger is sitting right over here. This time, I'm going to make it a little bit different because the monster truck is not limited in space. The monster truck is going to be about double the size compared to the wheelies. So let me just show you how I like this to look in the end. This is the throttle body. I bought another one compared to the wheelies. This is an automotive unit, and this features, I don't know if you can, let me turn it around. You see on the bottom there's a kind of a ramp, and this layout doesn't make it so responsive. That's a huge issue I have with the wheelies right now. Every tiny bit of throttle movement just opens the throttle so much that the engine is very very aggressive. So this one is a little bit easier. You can see that I need to move it quite a lot to really open it up. So this is the throttle body. It's going to be mounted with an aluminium adapter, which will be CNC machined. But just to give you a rough idea how I want it to look like, it will be mounted directly to the supercharger. I missed the opportunity to show you the rotors. It's just really a nice piece. And you can see from the rotors, it has hardly seen any driving. So this is really like a brand new unit. And it was like 200 euros. There will be an adapter plate which is going to move the throttle body a little bit higher afterwards, so it's going to be more like here. This will be about here. Yeah, it's kind of flimsy, but you get an idea. So just let me grab the camera. Okay. So the belt drive will be directly crank driven from here. Air comes in over there, goes through the supercharger, comes out of the supercharger, will be directly fed into the intercooler. And underneath here, you see there's still the small carburetor mounted, but this one will be removed. There will be a nice billet intake manifold. So it's the shortest ways possible. And what I really like is I can set it up however I want, because the monster truck is going to be so huge. Space is not a limiting factor. Yeah, and at least in my eyes, there's another huge announcement to make. And I told you that I'm going to replace about all kinds of engine parts. And in the end, I guess there will be only the stock crankcase used, and everything else is going to be replaced with forged, billet, whatever you can think of parts. Yeah, and I'm really proud to tell you that I found a partner for this project. I ordered through them before, and for this time, yeah, I was hoping for them to step in. And yeah, I did send an email, reached out to Tim from NR Racing, and he decided to do some kind of collaboration with me. So that means we created a huge package of parts. I'm going to do an unboxing, of course, to show you what kind of parts I've chosen. And Tim was so kind to give me some kind of special discount to make it a little bit easier for me to realize this project, because it costs tons of money, and yeah, this would not be possible without the help from, for example, Tim NR Racing. So I'm going to show you where you can find his website, and of course I'm going to link him in the description, and yeah, you can really look forward to the package, which will arrive shortly, and yeah, I'm very excited to see what's in there. Yeah, although the first test drive will be made without the body on top, I still need to care about the mounts for the body, and my plan is to make some kind of sheet metal on top of these holes on both sides, and put some threaded inserts in there to just hold the body in this area, maybe in this area, and of course in the front here and there. Like this on all four places I showed you before. So, and now it's time to install the inserts. This won't be the final solution, but as for now, it's a quick and easy way to secure the body. And yeah, it doesn't look too nice right now, but I will machine something nicer for the future. For now, it's enough.
these tests, I used my line lock system, which means I always kept the front brakes a little bit locked, just to keep the car under control and not losing it. For the next drive, it's quite obvious that I need to adjust the balance between throttle and brakes a little bit more, and the next drive will be so much nicer and faster. I'm sorry, this episode seems a little bit mixed because my plan for this episode was completely different up front, but after analyzing these driving shots, I'm quite happy because I see the potential of the car, and I know exactly what to do, and the next test drive will be done on a really huge parking lot with a nice adjustments between brake and throttle, and I'm pretty sure with the body mounted on top, it will be epic.
And in the last video, I asked you to estimate how much the chassis weighs without the body on it, and I don't know, hundreds of you commented, and this is the final result. So it's 88.35 kilograms or 194 pounds. I'm going to show the winners on that side right now, and I'm going to send them a message as well. Congratulations! I thought about a nice gift, and since I'm got a nice new logo for this channel, you're going to get a hoodie with the logo in front and in the back. Thanks to all of you who participated in this kind of small quiz. I'm going to do much more giveaways in the future. I think it's a nice idea, and it's a nice way to interact with you as the viewers. I really enjoyed that. So, thanks.